Fade is the 2005 Australian thriller. It was distributed by Force Entertainment and TLA Releasing by way of their Danger After Dark label. It definitely does spin on the traditional thriller. It definitely does challenge you to think, and it does try to take you out of your comfort zone. So it definitely is a very unique film. The film actually focuses mostly on the whole feeder gainer subculture. That's basically the whole basis for the film. There are two couples who are the focus of the film. We have Philip, who is a cybercrime police investigator, and his prostitute girlfriend. We also have Michael and Deirdre, and they basically are part of the feeder gainer subculture. Basically, Philip has traveled to America. I believe he's in Ohio tracking these cyber crimes. He believes the website isn't exactly what it claims to be. It's set up as a fetish website run by Michael, and it does star himself as well as his girlfriend Deirdre. She is 600 pounds. He is obviously just a normal guy. And that also does draw the parallel with Philip and his girlfriend as well. Obviously, they're the stereotypical young, attractive couple, but there's a lot of relationship dynamics as well in the film. Obviously, Philip is not very kind to his girlfriend. He's just very rough and unemotional, whereas Michael and Deirdre have a very tender, respectful, loving relationship. So it definitely does turn you on your heels, especially because you do see the scenes in which they are obviously intimate. But basically, Philip has traveled in pursuit of Michael because he believes there's something more going on with the website than the obvious, which he does uncover. And basically, the whole thing is Michael has basically been feeding Deirdre all kinds of things, as well as just remnants of other women which were previously featured on the site. The site is actually called We Love Lucy. And basically, he's been feeding Deirdre to death. And there's somewhat of a gambling ring tied in with this. People are literally betting on how much longer she will live, how much weight gain she will actually acquire before she does go. So there's definitely sort of a bit of a craziness going on there as well. There are some backstories with the characters as well. Michael obviously had an overweight mother. He did kill her, and he went off to, I guess, live with a priest and his family. He eventually was sent away because he had sort of an unhealthy infatuation with his adopted sister, who was also a big girl. And as far as Philip himself, his mother actually was a prostitute, so that kind of tries to tie in with his whole woman-hating deal. But it definitely is a very, very good story. It is a bit slow in some points, but it really does keep your interest. And what really does get you is at the end, in which Philip basically turns from hero to aggressor. He literally just shoots Deirdre live on camera and basically just sort of takes Michael as a hostage. So he is now basically starving Michael to death. So it's very much a case of letting the punishment fit the crime. Yeah, I definitely think it's a worthwhile film, very good. Very great storytelling. The characters are very well developed, very well acted. And if you do have the time, you should definitely take a look. It is definitely one of those films that will stay with you, but you won't regret it. So I will see you when I see you.